Hey, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to do an open box video and the manual installation of this ExpressLRS for radio link RC system from Happymodel that I purchased from Banggood.com. I will post the link where I purchased in the description. The model kit is a 915 MHz frequency radio link, which includes a transmitter and the receiver. It comes in a less expensive cardboard box than any other products on the market today. And that's where and the reason why I think you save the money on this product. But let's see what's included inside this box and how good they are. First, you're gonna find yourself with an SMA micro coaxial pigtail for the antenna and the IPEX connector on the other end for the transmitter PCB. A 2006 cooling fan. A JR compatible plastic box for housing transmitter PCB. And this ES900 transmitter PCB has a hardware revision 1.0 with a micro USB connector for updating the firmware. An ES900 receiver with ESP 8285 chipset, so you can wirelessly update the firmware through Wi-Fi or Betaflight pass-through connections. It comes with a beautiful CNC machined aluminum heatsink with matte finish. This the only reason that I purchased this product, because I know how hard it is to make this beautiful heatsink from aluminum extrusion. A cut to size thermal paste that is sandwiched between the aluminum heatsink and the transmitter PCB. The PCB gets really hot when you use above 200 milliwatts of power. A heatsink and a fan is a must, I think. So that's the reason why the DIY ExpressLRS 2.4 GHz doesn't include a heatsink, and they limit the power that you can use on that do-it-yourself ExpressLRS. As you can see here, is another reason why this product is so low on price, is that you gotta do it yourself. You need to apply this thermal paste onto the transmitter board, and it can get really hard sometimes. It took me like half an hour to get it done, but eventually I got it done. But if you're not that type of a person who likes to tinker with DIY, this might not be for you. It can get really frustrated to do this. All you need to do here is to keep it slow and work your way through the whole process slowly. Be patient, and eventually you're gonna get it good result. When this one done, you just gotta put 5 screws at the back of the PCB, screw it onto the aluminum heatsink with a tab already in place. I think these are the machine screw. I'm not sure the size of the screws. when it comes down to the SMA connector, be aware that it's not a fully circle. There's one flat. You just need to make sure that it's aligned with the plastic top cover shape so you can slide it right through. If you don't, you won't be able to slide this SMA connector through that hole on the top cover. And then use the included lock washer to tighten everything down. But before tightening everything down, I need to make sure that my coaxial cable is good. So I use my multimeter and set it to continuity testing to test for the coaxial cable to make sure that my cable is good. You never know, right? It might have some short circuit somewhere, or it might break the link. It can be bad for your transmitter. Okay, once I verify my coaxial cable is good, I use a little bit of hot glue at the base of the SMA connector where it connects with the coaxial cable. That is usually a weak point. And by doing this, it provides additional support for the coaxial cable. And at this point, it's a matter of putting all the screws together. For the fan, use three black plastic screws. For the BCB, use a tiny white plastic screw to tighten the BCB down into the box and the fan onto the top cover. Okay, we are almost finished putting things together, but I found another issue with this module. Is that the white plastic screws provided in this kit are too small. The thread on these plastic screws are too small to grab onto any of the plastic of the pre-drill holes on four corners of the box. So I had to search my toolbox for a replacement screws. I found some, but then I had to modify the box holes to make it bigger to accommodate for my own screws. In the end, it is not bad, but kind of turned off by this issue. Hopefully, Happymodel will provide with the correct plastic screws to fasten the cover down to the box securely and properly. Before turning it on though, please make sure that you have the antenna attached to the module first. Otherwise, it would damage the transmitter without the antenna. And this is the end of this video, and I hope that you liked it. Please support me by watching other videos that I have on my channel. I really appreciate it. Bye for now, and I'll see you in the next video.
Welcome to openTX. Switch warning.